What's up guys, welcome back to another video. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing the part 2 on how to edit with iMovie on your iPhone. A lot of you guys have been wanting a part 2 to this, so let's get started. So we're going to start off easy guys. The first thing I'm going to be showing you is how to insert your intro or outro. And if you guys don't know how to make an intro and outro on your iPhone, I'll leave a couple video links down below that I've made. But once you've created one, you just want to go on the little plus and you want to click on video and you want to just choose your video. And then you just want to tap on the plus and then it's just going to pop up your video. And all you got to do is just hold down and drag it all the way to the end of your video if you're doing an outro, or all the way to the beginning if you're adding your intro. So to add transitions to your videos, what you guys want to do is you want to go to the part of your video where you want to split and add the transition, and you just want to split, and then in between your two clips you'll have a transition slot. So you just want to tap on that and you'll have a bunch of different transitions to choose from. You guys can also choose theme, which has a few more transitions you guys could choose from. So if you click on the little settings icon in the right hand corner, you have a few more different transitions that are kind of hidden from the actual transitions tab. So I personally recommend the bright because the others really fit the news production type of category. So I would really recommend either of the two. You guys can also adjust the duration of your transition, so you can choose either half a second, 1 second, and even up to 2 seconds. Be showing you guys how to freeze a frame like a lot of YouTubers do. So to do that, all you have to do is just go to the part where you want to freeze your frame, and you just want to click on that little clock right at the bottom, and then you just want to tap on freeze, and then you'll have this little yellow bar and you can adjust the length of your freeze frame by dragging it to the right to make it longer or to the left to make it shorter. So the last thing I'm going to be showing you guys is how you can voice record on iMovie. So basically all you have to do is just go to the little plus and then you go to voiceover, and then it's just going to ask you to record and do like a little 3 second countdown, and you can just do your voiceover. It's really simple, but not a lot of people know about it, so I just wanted to also throw that in. You could also review your voiceover, and if you don't end up liking it, you can just tap on retake and redo your voiceover. You can also adjust the volume of your audio, and also another cool little tip is having a fade in, fade out effect with your audio. So if you click on fade on that right hand side, it'll give you two little triangles, and you can scroll it to the left depending on the duration of the fade, and I think it kind of gives a cool little effect, so you guys should definitely try that out as well. But anyway, that was it for the video. I really hope this video helped, and definitely be sure to check out my part 1 video down below, as that has more of the main features that I'll go through. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the